Listen, guys, listen. Sometimes I make a tweet and then like 6 to 8 months later, I finally follow through with it, okay? And that's just what this video is, all right?
In June, I said, I'm gonna do a vid where I try and give my best and honest advice. Use advice then, and I'll try and bestow you with my infinite wisdom. Whoops. okay, let's do it. Help, a YouTuber said he'd make a video on giving advice, but then he didn't. What should I do? How do I do taxes? Honestly though, how does this work?
This is such a good question because why don't they teach us this in school? Like this is, you have to do taxes. It's illegal for you not to do taxes once you start making money. So why don't they teach us how to do this?
I'm not like sponsored by them or anything, but TurboTax was really easy back when I did my own taxes because I have an accountant now, but using TurboTax was always really easy. But just, you know, make sure your employers give you the correct forms and whatnot, like W-2s, W-9s, 1099s, whatever the what are I-9s? There's a bunch of them. TurboTax is really easy. That's the only other way that I've done my taxes. It gives you a bunch of steps, again, not sponsored by them, but that's what I used back when I did my own taxes. Why don't they teach us this? I have no idea. Also, ask your parents or like a family member that is like a real adult, and hopefully they'll help you and walk you through it. Oh, sage young adult, how do you cope with self-imperfection and not being overly critical without turning into a mush of unproductiveness? This one's tough, because I have a lot of this where like I am pretty critical of myself, and there's a lot of times where I just feel like shit, and sometimes you gotta just take a day and just let yourself feel those feelings, you know? Sometimes you just gotta sit and realize that it's okay for you to just have a day where you don't do anything. And it kinda sucks sometimes where it's like, oh man, I really did nothing today.
But sometimes it's good. Sometimes it's good to just sit and do nothing and let yourself feel that way.
But I definitely have those days where I'm just like, oh man, I feel like I've done nothing and I feel like shit all the time and blah, blah, blah. And so that's something that's hard to get over sometimes. But it is, again, important to let yourself feel those feelings. I don't know how to not feel unproductive, but you know, maybe make a list. Lists help some people sometimes, or just like physically being able to like check something off. Also, don't give yourself too many things to do in a day, even if it's just one thing, even if it's just, I'm gonna go and like mail this thing that I've needed to mail for a year or whatever. Like that's a very specific scenario, but like I need to go and do this thing. I need to go to the bank, I need whatever you need to do. Like, don't give yourself too many tasks because then it's way too daunting. But, you know, maybe break it down a little bit and be like, okay, I'm gonna do these three things. How exactly would I go about telling my crush how I truly feel? I mean, it always depends on the situation, to be honest. But a lot of times just being open and honest is fairly, I mean, it's not easy to do. But you know, I don't know, just be like, hey, I just wanted to let you know that these are my feelings. If that's, you know, not something that you're feeling, that's fine. But I just kind of wanted to get this off my chest instead of holding onto these feelings forever. I don't know. And like sometimes even if they don't reciprocate those feelings, they're just like, oh, thanks for letting me know. Yeah, I don't feel that same way, but like, let's still be friends or whatever.
I don't know.
I'm always specifically bad at that.
What do you do when you drop your baby into a loose drain and they're screaming in the sewers asking for a friend?
Oh man, I've been through this situation many, many times where you're just like, oh no, my baby fell down a storm drain.
You know, I think getting a little rope and maybe putting a tasty treat, like a fruit snack on the end of it, and just putting it into the sewer, and then hopefully they'll go, ooh, fruit snack. And then they go and they chomp onto it, and then kind of like a fish, you just reel them back in.
How do you let go of people who aren't good for you? This is a good question and something that's really hard to do. But I think that it's a really important thing to do because I've had to do that before in my life where I'm like, oh, this person isn't healthy for me, or I just simply don't want to have this person in my life anymore. And sometimes it feels like it's a really harsh thing, but especially when it's like, oh, this person literally like mentally like stresses me out or makes me anxious or whatever. I think just saying, being brutally honest sometimes is really helpful and like, I don't, kind of the best thing to do in that scenario, because you don't want to lie or just like, I don't know, ghost them forever. I mean, that is a thing that you could do, I guess, is just ghost them forever, but then that gets complicated. But just be like, hey, like, honestly, I don't think that it's healthy for me to have you in my life. And like, there are certain things that really make me feel X way when we hang out, and I don't want that anymore. And I think that we should make it more of a thing that it's okay to like break up with friends, because friends, just like romantic relationships, are a relationship in itself, and sometimes relationships don't work out. And so I think it's totally fine to sort of break up with a friend and be like, hey, I don't think I really wanna like do this anymore. I don't wanna put the effort into this friendship or whatever it is. So yeah, I think just being honest and being like, hey, like, this is not doing it for me.
Yeah, exactly, Spencer, exactly. What? What are you so sad about? Oh, what are you upset about? Makes sense. Yeah, I get you.
I'm 18 now, and I don't know what to do with my life. I don't have a dream job or something like that. I'm scared. What am I supposed to do? First of all, don't think that you're alone in this, because I think a lot of people, especially when you're like 18 or right out of high school, people don't know what they want to do. It's kind of rare, honestly, for somebody to know like, oh, this is exactly what I want to do. And I think that's why a lot of people go to college and get a sort of like generic degree, like, oh, I'm going for business or I'm going for whatever, just because they're not really sure what they want to do yet. And that comes with getting experience, I think, and just having not only like job experience, but like life experience, and like figuring out like, oh, these are the certain things that I enjoy, even things like making friends and being like, oh, I really enjoy having like super deep conversations with people, or sort of like figuring out like how people's like brains work and stuff. And so then maybe if you like something like that, then like, oh, maybe I would like to like be a therapist or grow into psychology or something like that. But I think just having more life experience really helps you figure out what you actually want to do with your life.
Right, Spence? Would you agree?
No, but I definitely don't be stressed out about that, because I mean, it is stressful. It's valid to feel stressed out about it, but don't feel like you're the only one going through that. Don't feel like everybody else has their shit together, because they don't. And if they tell you that they do, they're probably lying, to be completely honest, because everyone's just trying to figure out their shit. I would just say, don't freak out about it as much as you can, and just try and get more life experience, and you know, you'll figure out what you love. Hope I'm not too late. How should I get over my ex? We were together almost 2 years and even planned a future together, but he broke up with me because he wanted freedom. This is a really tough thing. And again, like, I don't know your specific situation, but like, especially if it's like the first person that you're having like a real relationship with, it takes a really long time, to be honest. And like, it is something that unfortunately you can't just be like, oh, do this thing and then tomorrow it's better. It just takes time. And sometimes it's even like you don't start getting over it until you find another person or another thing to sort of occupy your time. Because especially like with this scenario, being together almost 2 years and stuff like that person is very much like not only your person, but also now sort of like a part of you. Because I think in relationships, especially longer term relationships, you and your partner sort of become each other in certain ways. Like you pick up certain mannerisms or certain habits and stuff like that. And so literally like a part of them is now sort of like a part of you. And so now you have to learn how to live without that part. And so yeah, it literally takes time. Try and distract yourself as much as you can, whether it's talking with friends or, you know, doing art or playing games or whatever. It's especially hard now just because you can't really go out right now. I mean, depending on the part of the world that you live in, but if you're in the US, you can't really and you shouldn't be going out. But yeah, I'm really sorry. That really sucks. But yeah, it just kind of takes time. But also understand that, just like what I was saying before, like, let yourself have those days, and it's okay to have those days where like you really miss that person, or like, you know, you just kind of sit in sadness, because it is sad and it really sucks. It fucking blows. Don't beat yourself up too much if you have days like that. it is really hard, and it just is something that gets better with time. How does one cope with the insanity of social media, especially in our current climate? Ah, man, this is something that I need to do. Take more breaks from it. I don't know, it's hard to do because it literally, for a lot of people, like for me too, it's like an addiction thing. Just the constant want slash need to check and refresh and figure out what people are saying and, you know, be in on the conversation or whatever. I think the biggest thing though is honestly taking regular breaks, which I wanna do more of, but like I deleted Twitter and Instagram off my phone for a week and it was so nice. Even just like, and I still went on it. Like I just was only allowing myself to check it if I was on my computer, which I mean, I am for most of the day, but not having it right here on my person was really helpful. And so, yeah, I think just taking regular breaks as much as you can. Also on the flip side of it, like if you are having negative interactions with people on social media and stuff, just remember that most people wouldn't actually say that stuff to your face. And also it's just like, boredom and attention seeking. So try not to take too much of what people say on the internet to heart, which is something that I need to do more of too. But yeah, try and take as many breaks as you can. It's important. How does one simply exercise or enjoy it? That's a good question. I think, at least for me, this has helped a lot. If you can find a way to exercise with somebody else and sort of have an accountability buddy, whether you're doing it over like FaceTime or whatever, or if you can safely do it in person, but having somebody else to work out with, whether it's like a friend or someone in your family, or like if you have like a personal trainer or anything like that, just having somebody else that, you know, you need to be responsible and be like, okay, we're gonna work out on this day, and this day. And then it just makes it easier to not miss, and having that external thing to be like, oh, I need to go and do this because somebody else is relying on me as well, is super, super, super helpful. So yeah, that's honestly my biggest tip. That's helped me a lot. Yeah, and I'm still bad at it. Sub or dubbed, subbed. I'm trans and struggling a lot with my family not accepting me. How do I continue to help myself knowing I don't have family, have my family behind my back? So I can't give you personal experience advice for this because I myself am not trans, but I would like to say, and I've heard a lot of different people say this, is that while you may have a blood related family, you know, you can also choose your own family. So if you don't have your like biological family supporting you, just don't forget that you may have another family in your friends or in a community or whatever supporting you, you know? And it does, I'm sure, like I can't imagine how hurtful that must feel to not have your direct family support. You know, in a perfect world, they would provide that support, but you can find that support in other ways through friends and stuff like that. And if they're not supporting you with who you truly are, then that's their loss too, not yours. And so just remember that while you're going through, I don't know if you have already or if you're currently transitioning or anything like that, but just know that they are in the wrong if they're not supporting you becoming like your true self. And I'm proud of you for making that step and for being so strong through that, because I can't imagine how stressful that whole scenario could possibly be, but I'm proud of you for taking those steps and becoming who you truly are. So congrats for that. Been trying to convince my parents that I'm responsible enough to get a dog, get a type of dog named a Texas Heeler. What can I do? I think from my memory, because Spencer might have a little bit of blue Heeler. So I think, I'm pretty sure Heelers are like working dogs, like farm dogs and herding dogs and stuff like that. And they can be a lot of work. And so I think that just like showing your parents that you're responsible enough for that, I think honestly the best way to do that without being like, without actually having the dog yet, is literally like creating a plan of like, hey, this is what I will do with this dog and this is how I will execute it. That wording was was bad. How to
execute the plan. But being like, I will take the dog out at this time. I will exercise the dog in this way. I will train the dog in this way, blah, 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 blah. This is how I will pay for the dog's needs and the food and any vet stuff like that. I don't know. It also like depends on what your parents are like too. But I think that would be the best way. It's just presenting like, hey, this is my plan. And if I stick to this plan, then everything will go as planned. How do you take control of your thoughts slash emotions when you have a panic slash anxiety attack? Oh boy. I don't know, dude. For me, and this is not for everybody, but for me, I did start taking medication to help with my anxiety, and it's helped a lot. But also just, I think communicating with people that you're close to is really, really important. It's really, really important because when you have those panic attacks or anything like that, if you're with people especially, you don't want to feel like you're more of a burden and you want to make sure that those people know how to properly react. Mika was really, really, really good about helping me out when I had panic attacks, and she could also just sort of like read my body language well and know when I was going to have a panic attack or anything. But I think communicating, hey, like this might happen sometimes and this is what I need you to do in these scenarios is really, really helpful, because if you don't communicate that, and sometimes it's hard to even figure out what is helpful, but even just being like, hey, I need you to like just remove me from whatever situation that we're in and just sort of like tell me that. Spencer, why are you growling so much?
What is up? What?
But just communicating what you need. You know, like, hey, I need you to distract me. Hey, I need you to sort of like talk me down and tell me that everything's okay. Hey, I need like physical affection or like a hug, or I need to not be touched at all, whatever it is. I think just clearly communicating that to the people that you're close with can help a lot.
Anywho, that was this video. I hope that any of my advice was helpful. Maybe I'll do another one of these in the future and not wait 40 million years to do it. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you like this different setup. It's kind of fun and just nice and refreshing to make something in my living room. Also that 4K, baby. Hope you guys are all having a good day. Hope you're staying safe. If you have advice for these specific questions, or if anybody else needs advice, you know, have a conversation in the comments. Give your own advice, ask for advice. Anyway, see you later. What is up, my cranky crew?